flashcards are a very important learning resource for the children, and we have them in the books that we have sent to you. So we are going to introduce you to the flashcards from the World of Numbers Level 2. 1 to 20 with the values, and then 10 to 90 to build number values. And then you have the subtraction, the greater than, lesser than, the equal to, and the addition sign. And you have a very interesting set of flashcards called the number rods. What I'm going to help you to do very, very quickly is to see how these resources can be used with children. To start off with, I would suggest that you buy a little bit of colored chart paper and cut the four basic shapes for the children. You could cut the triangle, the squares, the rectangles and the circles, and then use it for sequencing. As the children are already in level 2, they can sequence with more attributes than one. But start with single attributes. For example, if you're doing circles, then take circles of all the colors. So first let them sort out the colors. It could be just sorting of colors. Start with sorting and then start with sequencing. So you can sort out the shapes, you can sort out the colors, and then encourage the children to sequence. So red, yellow, red, yellow. You can make it more complicated. You can ask them to do red, yellow, blue, red, yellow, blue. Make it even more complicated. So as the children keep getting better at it, keep adding more colors, keep adding more shapes. For example, you can say, you can take a triangle, a circle, a triangle, a circle. So gradually the children learn how to use two attributes, and then you can add the third attribute, and so on and so forth. So you must start an activity like this. Do a lot of pre-number concepts, big, small, thick, thin, with resources, with materials from around your house, and then start with the numbers. We have these sets of flashcards which I'm using. The set of 1 to 9 is the most used set for level 2, because with that you do the addition, you do the number building, you do the subtraction, and you do a whole range of activities with that. So we will use, you will make your bundles. Always tear out the cards from the perforation. For the level 2, you will make a bundle from 1 to 9, 10 to 20, 10 to 50, 60 to 90, and these little signs will be the fourth bundle, and then you have the bundle with the number rods. So you will have more bundles for these children. Also teach them how to sort out the bundles, how to take care of them. That's what we do in schools as well. So it really helps you. Even the strips that you have above and below, these strips that you have above and below can be collected and used as counting strips. You can use the flashcards with the pages of the book. For example, when you want the children to actually build numbers, you can ask them to arrange the values above the books from 1 to 9. And suppose you want the child to build the number 11, 10 and 1, 11, 10 and 1, 11. To take it further, you can actually ask the children to take these little strips and count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, and ask them to make a bundle. So you make one bundle, get them small rubber bands, these small rubber bands which they can make a bundle. So 10 would be 1, 10 and one more. They can always make the bundle down. The same thing can be done for every number. You can do, the 10 in 2, 10 in 3. Then you can go to the 20s, the 30s. So each number can be taught to be built like this. You can actually tell them to make bundles of 10. You can use beads. You can use the fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and a bundle. So you can teach them how to do the 10s and 1s so beautifully and build the numbers from 11 to 99. The books can be used for that. You can also take the cards and ask the children to turn it over and build it with just the cards. So 10 and 1, 11. 10 and 1, 11. So once the number is built, do not encourage them to break the number up. This they must say as 11, 12, 13, 14 when they write it. It's only when they build the number that you ask them to break it up and build it. So it's really interesting because what we can do after that is when you do the greater and the lesser than, you can show them the value of 10 and 1 or 10, 20 and 3, 23. Ask them which is more. Rather than teaching children big and small numbers, it's nice to teach them more and less and then help them to identify the bigger number, the more and place it like this. Gradually, you can actually turn over the numbers and the children can start associating the numbers with the values. This is how these little flashcards can be used. Always encourage them to put them back in order. It would help children to do that and it will help you to organize the activity. So, all right. So, I'm going to remove these now. The number building, which you can do with these numbers of 10. Suppose the children want you to addition. You can use the number rods and you can use your cards from 1 to 9. For example, if you want the children to build a number, addition 1 plus 3 is equal to. So what they can do is, they can put a 1 here. They can put a 1, 2 and 3 here. And because they have to add it up, they can say after what they can actually put all these together and count them and say 1, 2, 3, 4 and take the card of 4 and place it here. Because addition means counting two numbers together. So rather than putting 1 here and 3 here and 4 here, it's better if they pick up the 1 and 3 and combine it and place it here as an answer. So you can build a lot of sums like this for the children. These are just a few activities. Of course, the addition is going to come a little later in the year. And also teach them how to sort out, place the numbers back in order. You can use the values, you can use the number cards and help the children do different activities. So the 1 to 9 is very, very important at this level. Each time you finish the activity, encourage them to collect it properly and bundle it and place it. This is how we work in schools. Now, for example, if we want to do the activity with the number rods, this is how you work on it. Preferably, you should be using the ones without the numbering. So 1 plus 2. Right? So what would it be? After 1, 2 and 3. So what is the number? It's 3. Let's check it out. Is it equal to 3? Yes. You could use it with the numbers as well. So you can take different number combinations. Like for example, 3 and 4. So after 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. When you're going to do counting like this, it's always good to not have the numbers visible. So after 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, then the children can pick up the number rod of 7 and check if it is equal then they have done it correctly. Also, this is a very nice activity to do number bonds. For example, you pick up a number 7. So how many ways can you make 7? So after 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 2 and 5 will make 7. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, let's check. 1 and 6 will make 7. What else can make 7? Let's put 3 here and see. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So 3 and 4 will make 7. These are the way that number bonds can be done with the children. So you can do addition, you can do number bonds, and you can do the counting from 1 to 10, backward from 10 to 1. These are a few variations. You can think of more.